What's up everybody, welcome to a new video. Today we will talk about how to lose muscle while gaining weight. Wait a minute. There are basically these two ways how most people do it. Option A, you build up muscle and then you lose weight. And option B, you lose weight first and then you build up muscle. But is there actually a way to do both? The answer is yes. And the whole process is called recomping. And it doesn't matter if you have access to a gym or not, if you have weights or not, the principle is always the same. But there are some important points which you must keep in mind. Before we continue, I'm happy to present you the sponsor of today's video.
I guess you know what birch trees look like, but did you ever hear about birch sap or birch water? As a traditional beverage in northern and eastern countries of Europe, it contains a bunch of minerals, antioxidants, especially manganese, and vitamins. Plus, it has basically no calories. ÖselBirch is a company which offers various healthy birch water products like non-fermented and fermented birch water and other birch-based supplements. And all of that in different tastes and flavors. Definitely check out ÖselBirch and their products. I left the link in the description below.
Alright, the first point is obviously your diet. As you know, to lose fat, you must burn more calories than you consume. But here is the problem. Muscle protein synthesis and your workout efficiency and your energy levels during a workout highly depend on your calorie intake. Multiple studies could confirm that a calorie deficit is associated with a lower protein synthesis, and this is obviously a big problem. You will feel more powerless during the workouts due to the lack of energy. Why is this the case? It is of course a combination out of different things, but calorie deficit influences your insulin secretion. You might have heard already about insulin from diabetes, and insulin opens up the cells and lets all these nutrients, proteins, and of course also sugar enter the cell. Therefore, it basically acts as a key. And for your metabolism and the energy production in the cell, insulin therefore plays a crucial role. So, what's the solution? In order to lose fat, you have to be in a calorie deficit. There is no way around it. But do not go into a deficit of more than 20%. That is an average of around 500 calories. The more you weigh, the closer you can get to the 20%. But if you're just slightly overweight, then I would not really recommend that you immediately hit the 20%, but 10% would also be absolutely enough. By the way, I made another video about why not all calories are the same, so definitely check that out as well. The three big players making up your calories are proteins, fats and fatty acids, and of course, carbs. Your protein intake should be on a high level at all times because, as you know, protein is the main contributor to muscle growth. Regarding fat, there is this misconception that fat is always bad. But fact is, you should never avoid fat completely. Physiologically, fat has the greatest amount of energy, and for your performance and especially for your health, you must consume a certain amount of it. Here you can see the recommended macronutrient distribution making up the calories. Let's say you weigh 90 kilograms or 200 pounds and you consume 2500 calories after this distribution. And you are maybe slightly overweight. You should cut down your overall calorie intake to 10%, so we are left with, I think, 2250 calories. Yes. Then you reduce your fat and carbohydrate consumption slightly and you increase your protein intake. But this is of course no rule, that's just an example what I would personally suggest. Well, now we talked about the diet a lot, but what about the workout? And I'm sure you ask yourself, what exactly should I do now? Cardio, lifting or what? Regarding fat loss, you must understand that your workout makes up only maybe 20% maximum, while nutrition is the rest. Don't understand me wrong, nutrition is crucial for building up muscle, but if you will not give your muscles the right stimuli, they won't grow either. Obviously, I actually don't need to tell you that. Regular workouts are the foundation of what we talk about here in this whole video. You must stimulate your muscles on a regular basis and give them enough stimuli to grow. And if you don't give them the stimuli, they won't. Therefore, add variations to your workout and increase intensity and or frequency step by step. And if you need some inspiration, definitely check out these videos on my channel. I'm sure they will help you a lot. I recommend that you train your muscle at least 2 to 3 times a week. And what's always a good idea is resistance training with progressive overload. By the way, too much or excessive cardio can also diminish your gains. So if you want to build up muscle at the same time, I would say it's not ideal. Exercising regularly also boosts the levels of testosterone and other growth hormones, which will help you in building up muscle and lose fat at the same time. The last thing I want to talk about is the role of sleep and stress. We don't build up muscle during the workout. We, in fact, destroy our muscle fibers. But the recovery and the buildup happen during night. This is already reason enough to take care of enough sleep. But not only that, a good sleep also reduces stress and therefore cortisol levels. And cortisol is kind of counteracting testosterone and neutralizing its positive effects. The take-home message for today is: strive for fat loss, but not for weight loss. The goal is not to look skinny, but to look muscular. And it is possible. You can burn muscle while you gain fat. Before you click away, don't forget to subscribe for more videos. Stay healthy and see you next time.